Hey guys, I got a little reach-in cooler here. I rode it out of the kitchen area so I can have better workspace and get out of their way. So I got an outlet. I can plug in here. Let's see what we got going on. Fan spinning. I think this might have tripped. Got to set out. Compressor's really, really hot. So I'm gonna start checking the starting components, and so far so good. All right, got it cooled off. Got my amp meter on there. Let's see what she's gonna do now. I couldn't find nothing grounded, so I left it unplugged so that only my condenser fan would run, my evap fans, to make sure everything else is good. Just to eliminate it from the equation. Alright guys, so I'm back. Replace this compressor. Start getting this refrigerant out. Alright, gotta set it out. There's no ports on here, so I'm just gonna cut it, bring the little port on here, open that up, and take whatever's in it out. And then start getting everything out, change this filter dryer, the compressor. Alright, something to be aware of, I just noticed, is my suction line and discharge lines. That's how they're oriented. And on the new one, they're backwards. Suction is actually on the bottom, discharge on top. See, it's a bigger processing tube. When I Google the model number, I'll show a picture of it. It shows you suction, discharge. It's backwards out. Discharge on bottom, suction on top. Suction on bottom, discharge on top. And then your processing tube. Alright, so I braze a quick stubby on here real quick so that I can make sure the cap tube's clear, make sure it's coming out. So I got my gauges open already, so I just gotta open the nitrogen and should fall through. Yep. Legs on. All right, got all my fittings in. I got the thermal trap, trying to help from the heat. So go ahead and start brazing. Thank you. Turn the pressure test. Got both sides open. Yellow side is open. Go ahead and check the leaks. Alright, she's been holding at about 150. So, I'm gonna go ahead and put on vacuum. Got it on vacuum. So, I'm gonna go ahead and put these new hard start capacitor. Do all the electrical walls on vacuum. Alright, so this needs 10.2 ounces of 134. So, I gotta zero it out, set to ounces. All I gotta do is crank the ball valve. Alright, I just plugged it in. Checking the amp draw. Got 5.1 amps on the compressor. Got a hot discharge. Cold suction. Warm liquid line. Both sides. So far everything's looking good. I'm gonna let it run, put my temperature in the unit, check the temperature, make sure it drops down. Alright, I'm gonna keep an eye on it, let it run for a bit. Right now we're at 60 in the box. She's coming down, so she's down to temp. I'm gonna make sure she cuts off, make sure the thermostat's set properly, but looks like that's gonna be it. I marked it too, so the next guy will know about the repairs done on this already. I'm sure you could tell too, just by seeing the service ports and the fittings I had to put on here. But looks like that's gonna be it on this one, guys. I'm gonna put this one up. Another one done.